Hi guys, welcome to WebSense Pro, welcome to another tutorial video. So Shopify released Horizon themes a few weeks back and they added a ton of functionality, but they also removed some of the functionalities. So let's suppose you wanted to have a pagination, but it's no longer existed in the Horizon themes. It was available in Dawn theme, but in Dawn theme, there was no option to add infinite scroll. So if you're still using Dawn theme and you want to add infinite scroll, there's a link in the description through which you will be able to add that. I have already created a video tutorial for that, but in new Horizon theme, it's always infinite scroll. There is no option to enable or disable the pagination, but after watching this tutorial, you'll be able to add a feature where you can simply enable or disable the pagination on the collection pages. If I show you guys the collection page with the pagination, so I have this all product collection page with the 22 items. Where currently only 5 is showing up and we have this pagination showing up, right? So that is the feature which you will be getting after watching this tutorial video, and that's how it is going to work. You can change the number of items shown in one single page. So let's suppose you want to display 10 items on one page or 8 items or whatever number of items you want to display in one single page. You can add that, and you can also disable the pagination and make it the default behavior. So that's the default behavior in all of the Horizon themes. You can see that it's opening up the products. So let's suppose you have 200-300 products in one single collection. It is going to load completely with the infinite scroll, which may take a lot of time to load or increase the load time. So it is better to have the pagination if you have a collection with like 200-300 or many products on that collection. So it's really good to have that. So we will be adding this feature on our Horizon theme, and let me show you the backend. So if I open the theme customizer, okay, so that's our collection page and you can see the pagination. And if I open this collection section from the collection template, you can see that we have these options for pagination, and I can decrease and increase the pagination. So currently 5 products are displaying. I'm going to change it to 10 and then hit save. And now I'll have 10 products showing up. 3, 6, 9, 10. Yep, we have 10 products showing up. And here we have the option to change the link color and change the background color and styling for that. So if I want to change the, let's say I want to change to something different, similarly for the link color. There you go. You can see that the colors are changing and working fine. I'm going to switch it back again. And we also have the option to change the hover color, right? And we can simply disable it if we don't want on some collection. So let's suppose you have multiple collections and one of the collection you have like 200 or 300 products. You're going to create a new template, assign that template to that collection, and then add the pagination. And for the rest of the collection, you will not need to add any pagination. So you can arrange it like that, right? So wherever you don't need it, you can simply deactivate that, and it is going to remove the pagination, and it is going to add the infinite scroll, which is the default behavior of all the new Horizon themes, right? In Dawn theme, there were no option to add infinite scroll. So I created that tutorial when there was no option. And if you're still using Dawn theme and don't want to update to Horizon theme, that's completely up to you. I have created a lot of tutorials for Dawn theme, adding transparent header, just like on my screen. Adding the animated mega menu, creating this stylish looking slider, and having this person discount badge. By the way, I've also created person discount badge for Horizon theme, which is the latest video we released last week. So there's a collection slider and a ton of different sections which I have created, which is also usable in Horizon theme. So most of the sections can be used in Horizon theme as well. Let's suppose this pricing table plan, which we added on Dawn theme, it can still be used in Horizon theme as well. Similarly, this stylish looking double marquee animation, which you can also add. I mean, there are a lot of sections, so make sure to subscribe to the channel and check out the other videos which I have created. Now let's dive into this tutorial where I'm going to show you how you can implement that. So let's go to the store. And as you can see, it is not an updated version. So I am going to install the latest version of Horizon theme in order to show you guys how it's gonna work. So that's the Horizon theme. So all of these themes are using the same code base. Horizon, Saver, Vessel, Heritage, all of these themes are basically same by the code. It's just the layout and the styling is different. So no matter whatever theme you use, it's going to work completely fine. I'm going to use this one and add the Horizon theme. And guys, while this theme is being stored, if you are new to Shopify, there's a link in the description. If you sign up through that link, you will get your store for just $1 a month. Yes, you heard it right. It's just going to be $1 a month. So you can start your new business. You can start your e-commerce online business with just $1 a month. Really cheap, and all of the functionality from Shopify you will be getting. Link in the description. Make sure to sign up through that link. Okay, guys, our Horizon theme has been stored. I'm gonna hit publish and then click on publish again. Okay, it's now published. And now let's preview the collection page on this one before adding any code or customization. So that is my Horizon theme. And I'm gonna open up the collection where I have all of the products. So this is a collection which lists all of the products. So that's how it currently works, right? With all of the products showing up on infinite scroll, no matter how many products you have in that collection. I currently have only 22 items, but you may have more than 22 items. You may have 100 or 200 items in that collection. And if I go to the customize settings and open up the collection, you will not find any pagination option here. Shopify might add it later down the road, but currently there is no feature to add pagination, which I'm gonna show you how you can add. So let's go to the code editor, and in order to open the code editor, click on these three small dots and then click on edit code. Now guys, I'll be doing the code changes, and these code changes are sometimes not properly done by you guys, and I received a lot of comments and complaints that the code which you provided broke our theme. So it's suggested to have a duplicate of your theme. If you're working on a live website, make sure to have a duplicate version of your theme before adding any code. And if you think that it broke your theme, or if it has any functionality issues, you can simply revert it back, right? So it's, you should be safe to use these code, because the code sometimes break other things, or the code sometimes actually behave a little differently because of the implementation you have done wrongly. So make sure to have a duplicate of your theme. And that is the tutorial which we will be following. You will find the link of this tutorial in the description, where we have the step-by-step implementation of what code we need to add in, right? So first step is to replace the code of main-collection.liquid file. And I am gonna do that. So in the code editor, I am going to search for main-collection. And I'm going to replace all of this code. So currently remove all of the code and add the code which is here. So it's basically the same code with a few added schema settings and few added custom codes. And it is easier that way to copy the whole code. And if you want me to show you guys the implementation of each and every single code, let me know in the comments below. I'll create another video where I'll explain you guys which code is working how. And if I get enough requests, I'm definitely gonna create another video to explain you guys how code is actually working line by line, whatever the changes which I made. Okay, so that was the first step which we completed. Now let's move on to the second step. So in here, we will replace the product-grid.liquid file code. So let's search for product-grid. Here's the file, product-grid.liquid. Again, we will replace all of the code here. So I'm removing the current code and add in this code which is here, and then paste the code and then hit save. Okay, before moving on to the next step, guys, I would like to introduce the app which is called Big Bulk Discount. This is our own built app, and we have received a lot of feedback that adding volume discount or tier-based discount increase the sales. And if you also want to increase the sales by adding tier-based discount and have this stylish looking widget on your product page, this is the app for you. It is available for 7-day free trial, so you don't have to pay a single penny and use it completely for free for 7 days. And if you think it contributes to the sales and add in more sales to your store, you can keep using it. Otherwise, you can simply uninstall, right? Okay, now let's move on to the next step for our pagination. So that's our third step, where we will be creating a new snippet. And the snippet file should be exactly the pagination.liquid. The name should be exactly pagination.liquid. Make sure not to change the mistake in spelling for that file. I'm going to create a new snippet by clicking on this add a new snippet button, and I'm going to name it pagination, right? Dot liquid is automatically added. Let's click on done. And now I am going to add this code, which is here. So click on copy code and then paste the code here and click save. Perfect. We have successfully completed the code implementation. And now if we go back to our customize settings and go to collection, scroll down, you can see that we have this pagination showing up here. And if I hit refresh to my collection page, so you can see without refresh, we don't have any pagination. Now if I refresh, I'll have the pagination showing up. Okay, I think I'll have to preview that. Yep, here it is. I had to refresh a few times in order to see the pagination. So you can see that we have this pagination showing up, and on one single page, we have 10 products showing up. So if I click on the second one, we will have another 10 products. And on the last page, it will be 2 products because I have 22 products in this collection, right? So you can do that, and all of the remaining functionality is intact. It is not gonna affect any other functionality. Just adding this pagination that it will do. And again, you can change the products per page. So if I switch it to, let's say 15 and then hit save, it is going to display 15 products. Here we have the 15 products showing up, right? And changing the link color, active link color, and hoverbg, I already show you guys how you can do that. And if you want to disable, you can simply disable the pagination. Cool, right? So if you are looking to add in pagination to your store built with Horizon theme or any other newly created theme from Shopify, this is the tutorial. Let me know in the comments below if you want to learn more about Horizon theme. I'll definitely create more video. Until next video, have a great day.